Morning students, in the last lecture we started this lesson from the diary of Anne Frank and we have read some part of this chapter. Today we will complete this chapter and we will discuss about the theme also. So before we start this part, let's revise the story what is given in the lesson. In the beginning it is given that this lesson has been taken from the diary of Anne Frank. She had written that diary when she was in Netherlands in hiding and she was staying with her family. At that time she started writing the diary and she wrote about her family, her friends, and she has given honest opinion about all these people around her. And what she has told in this lesson in the beginning, that how they faced Nazi's tortures and how they were they had to go in hidings as the Nazi's rules extended in Netherlands also. And after that she has also told about her family, that she has her sister, elder sister Margaret, her father Otto Frank, her mother also, and they were all living together. And now this part starts with her first entry in the diary on the date that was 20th. This is given there, 20th June 1942, and from there she started writing the diary pages. So we will study that what she has written on the first page of her diary after the introduction part, what she has written about. In this part, she has discussed about her school life. It was all normal. They were leading a very normal life before going to the hidings or all that. How they were studying in the school. So this is all given. So let's read that one now. So Saturday, 20th June 1942. Dearest Kitty, as she has named this Dearest Kitty, she has named this diary Kitty. So what she expresses in that. Our entire class is quaking in its boots as she has discussed the school life. So what she says that all the classmates are quaking in boots. They are trembling with fear, quaking in boots. And you note down the important word meanings in your book or not. The reason of course is the forthcoming meeting in which the teachers decide who will move up to the next form and who will be kept back. Actually, now the discussion, why they were trembling in fear, because the result was to be declared and many were fearful that whether they would be promoted to the next form, next grade or not. Half the class is making bets. They are just making bets that who will go to the next class or not. GN and I, GN is Anne Frank's friend and I refers to Anne Frank, laugh ourselves silly at the two boys behind us. Actually, they were sitting in the class and behind them there were two boys and they were just these two friends and her friend. They were laughing at them. Why? Because these two boys are CN and Jacques, who have staked their entire holiday saving on their bet. They have just made bets, shirt laga rahe hain dusre se, and they are just guessing that who will get through or not. And what they are saying from the morning to night, it's you are going to pass, no I am not, yes you are, I am not. All the time they were saying the, repeating the same line that you will be passing the exam, I will not be passing the exam. They were arguing like that and they had already staked their amount, their money on these bets, these kind of bets. Even G's pleading glances and my angry outburst can't calm them. Even pleading, GN is quite requesting more, and N is quite angry. And both these expressions, requesting expressions or angry expressions, they could not change them and they kept on doing the same. If you ask me, there are so many dummies about that, about a quarter of the class should be kept back. Now what she says, what Anne Frank's opinion is, that many of her classmates are dummies, they are stupids, and one fourth of them 1/4 of them, they should be kept in the same class. They should not be promoted at all, because they are all stupid. But she says that teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on earth. She says that, but you cannot guess what the teachers can do. Sometimes they promote somebody, or if somebody gets failed, you can never guess about the teacher's opinion. So these are all unpredictable. You cannot make any guesses. I am not so worried about my girlfriends and myself. So what she says that whoever my female friends are and I, we are not worried about our result because we will get through, definitely. The only subject I am not sure about is maths. I am not sure about only maths. And anyway, all we can do is wait. So what she says that we can't do anything, but we can just wait for the results. Until then, we keep telling each other not to lose heart. And we are just asking, just consoling each other that everything would go well and we should not worry at all. I get along pretty well with all my teachers. Now what she says that I have good rapport in my school. All my teachers, they like me. Except one thing, there are 9 of them, 7 men and 2 women. She says that there are 9 teachers who teaches me. And Mr. Kissing, the old fogey means old fashioned man, who teaches maths, was annoyed with me for ages because I talked so much. But she says that my maths teacher, he is not happy with me because I always create noise in the class. I am very talkative. And that's why he's always annoyed, always angry with me. After several warnings, he assigned me extra homework. Now, he warned me many times when I did not correct my ways. He assigned me extra homework. Extra homework, what kind of extra homework? An essay on the subject, a chatterbox. He gave me an essay, to write an essay on the topic, a chatterbox. Chatterbox is also, it's called also talkative. A chatterbox, what can you write about that? Now, she was confused that what she should write, how she could write an essay on that topic. I would worry about that later, I decided. Now, she was not worried. She thought, what I should write on that, I would think later. I jotted down. Jotted down means written down the title in my notebook. She wrote the title in the notebook, put that in the bag, and try to keep quiet, and she just tried to keep quiet so that teacher should not be annoyed at all. That evening, after I had finished the rest of my homework, the note about the essay got my eye. Now, when she had completed her homework at home, after that she just remembered that she has been given an essay also. So I began thinking about the subject by chewing the tip of my fountain pen, and she started thinking about the topic, that what she should write in that. Anyone could ramble on and leave big spaces between the words, but the trick was to come up with convincing arguments to prove the necessity of talking. And what she says that if there is any other student, what they would do, they would leave much space and they would write anything foolish about that essay, and they would just submit that it's a part of homework and they have submitted it. But she wanted at that age, she wanted to write something convincing that her teacher should also agree with this point, her point that why she is talking in the class and she should never be stopped while talking. So she just wanted to give some convincing arguments. Convincing argument, that a statement made such a manner that people believe it. She wanted to be like that. And that shows that she was quite intelligent also. She was not like a normal child who always do the same, but she wanted something different. And I thought and suddenly had an idea, and she suddenly got an idea, and she wrote 3 pages for that. 3 pages for that essay. 3 pages Mr. Kissing had assigned me and was satisfied. And she was satisfied to write that essay, and teacher was also satisfied to read that one. I argued. Now what she had written in that essay, I argued that talking is a student's trait. When students talk in the class, it is their trait, it is their habit, it is their character. They are to talk, and that I would do my best to keep it under control. And what she said is that it is definitely talk about, but I would keep it under control. And second argument that she gave is, but that I would never be able to cure myself of the habit since my mother talked as much as I did, if not more, and that there is not much you can do about inherited traits. And second one, what she says that her mother is also very talkative, and that is also an inherited quality in her. Inherited quality means qualities that one gets from her parents. So what she says that as my mother is also very talkative, so I must be talkative. So you cannot stop it. Mr. Kissing had a good laugh at my arguments. He had a good laugh when he read the essay. He laughed at this, but I thought that he is happy now that I gave strong arguments in favor of being talkative. But after that, when I proceeded to talk my way through the next lesson, when she's just trying to talk in the next class also, he assigned me second essay. Now teacher assigned next essay, and this time it was supposed to be an incorrigible chatterbox. Now this time he had assigned her another essay that was also on the same topic, but that was incorrigible chatterbox. Incorrigible is something which cannot be corrected. So incorrigible chatterbox, and I handed it in, and Mr. Kissing had nothing to complain about for two whole lessons. Now again she wrote one wonderful essay, and Mr. Kissing was satisfied, and for the next two lessons there was no problem. But after that, during the third lesson, he had finally had enough. Now again she started talking. So next time, third time, he again assigned her one more essay, and this time the essay was, "Anne Frank, as punishment for talking in the class, write an essay entitled Quack, 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 Said Mistress Chatterbox." So you have to write an essay on that. Quack, quack is also talking, since it is quacking, continuously talking. So it was also again, an essay was given. So this time the class lowered, the class started laughing. I had to laugh too, though I had clearly exhausted my ingenuity on the topic of chatterbox. Now, but what she said is that I had already written two essays and I had no more genuine idea on how to write this essay, what I should write on that. So it was the time to come up with something else, something original. So this time she wanted to write, she wanted to add something different, something original. And my friend Sanin, who is good at poetry, offered to help me. And this time her friend Sanin, who was good at poetry, she just decided to help her. How she decided to help her? The essay from beginning to end in words, and I jumped for joy. And what she said, what she offered, that she would write the essay in the form of poetry, and I was very happy, and Frank was very happy for that. Mr. Kissing was trying to play a joke on me with the ridiculous subject, but I would make sure the joke was on him. This time she wanted to prove that this joke which was played by a teacher on her, that should go back to the teacher. I finished my poem and it was beautiful. Now she finished the poem, she wrote the poem, and it was really very beautiful. It was about a mother duck and three duck and a father swan, and three baby ducklings who were bitten to death by their father because they quacked too much. It was a story of a duck and swan and three ducklings, and father just put them to death because they quacked too much, they talked too much. And luckily Mr. Kissing took the joke the right way. Now this time Mr. Kissing was happy to find the essay, and he took it in a positive way. He read the poem to the class, adding to his comments, and he read this poem in the class and adding some comments, and to several other classes that he liked that so much. And since then I have been allowed to talk and haven't been assigned any extra homework. And after that I was not assigned any extra homework and I was allowed to talk in the class. He was convinced with that. On the contrary, Mr. Kissing always making jokes these days. Now even Mr. Kissing had changed his ways and he started cracking jokes in the class. So he had changed. He had become a lively person. So this is what Anne Frank was. It is just a reflection of how she was in the school. She was a very intelligent girl. and how she did in all that, because at that age, at the age of 13, when she wrote that diary, which is still so relevant, you can imagine that before 1944, so she had written that diary, completed her diary, and at the age of just 14-15 years. And this you can imagine that how strongly she had put forth her ideas and how she has added those qualities of her parents, her teachers and all that. And this is all about the theme also, that she has clearly depicted about the family and all that, and when they were in hiding in Amsterdam, her frankness, honesty and sincerity of description of her parents, friends and teacher make her writing the most important document of the Holocaust period. So this is all about the theme and the story.